Welcome to Back to Basics. In this episode, we are going to cover the various options to offload TLS certificates for your applications in the cloud. Some time ago, I had helped the customer's network engineering team design their architecture for ingress traffic. The customer's security team had categorized applications based on different compliance and privacy requirements. There were also a set of applications which did not want to do the undifferentiated heavy lifting of terminating TLS within their application. We were pondering the various trade-offs to offload the TLS certificates and achieving operational efficiency. Let's dive into some of the options we discussed. The TLS protocol addresses network security problems such as tampering and eavesdropping between a client and a server. AWS services support TLS to encrypt the network traffic in transit. Let's explore the options to offload TLS certificate on an elastic load balancer for applications communicating with one another. Depending on your application requirements, you can either use an application load balancer or a network load balancer to expose your applications. If your application has requirements for L7 features such as path-based forwarding based on HTTP requests, or your application uses L7 protocols such as gRPC, you would typically use an ELB. If you have requirements for advanced API management such as throttling, you would use API Gateway. With ELB, you can offload the SSL termination at the ELB layer. The load balancer uses a server certificate to terminate the front-end connection and then decrypt the requests from the client before sending them to the targets, thereby offloading the implementation logic of SSL validation from your applications to an ELB. ELBs also support mTLS, thereby authenticating both the clients and the server at the ELB layer. Note that with this approach, connection tracking is done on ELB, where tens of thousands of client connections are tracked versus on backend target, which will see a connection only from the ELB. Depending on the security requirements, you can have a HTTPS target for an ELB. The load balancer establishes a TLS connection from with the targets using the certificates that are installed on the targets. The load balancer does not validate these certificates. Therefore, you can use self-signed certificates or the certificates that have expired. Because the load balancer and its targets are in a virtual private cloud, traffic between the load balancer and the targets is authenticated at a packet level, so it is not at risk of man-in-the-middle attacks or spoofing even if the certificates on the targets are not valid. If your application is utilizing sockets programming, leverages L4 protocols such as TCP, UDP, you can leverage NLB to expose your service to your clients. An NLB allows two modes of a TLS termination. You can offload the TLS termination at the NLB layer, similar to ALB. With this, you achieve benefits such as source IP preservation, that is, the source IP address and the port is presented to your backend servers, even when the TLS is terminated at the NLB. You also gain benefits such as simplified management. Using TLS at scale means that you need to take responsibility for distributing your server certificate to each of the backend servers. This creates extra management work, sometimes involving a fleet of proxy servers, and also increases your attack surface due to presence of multiple copies of the certificate. Terminating the TLS at NLB removes all the complexity and gives you a central management point for your certificates. If your security team requires an end-to-end TLS encryption, NLB allows TLS passthrough directly to the backend server without having to re-encrypt the traffic at the NLB layer. ALB and NLB form the core to offload TLS termination from your application logic. If your organization is looking to adopt service mesh for microservices to communicate with one another, VPC Lattice also offers TLS termination. It's essential to determine the application requirements, the security requirements, and operational overhead to choose the right AWS resource to determine where to offload TLS. Check out the links in the description below for more details. Thank you for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.